Yeah, hi. Today we are going to learn about the triggers. So what is a trigger? Trigger is nothing but it is an object in the T-SQL. It is also one type of object, same as tables. We got one. Table is also one type of object. Store position also is one type of object. Index is also one type of object, because all objects you use by creating, right? Create and you give object type, and after that you give object name. Same way for trigger also you do the same thing. And here trigger means it executes when an event occurs, update, delete or insert. There are many triggers. So basically there are two types of triggers, for, after, both are same. And then next is the instead of. So there are two types of triggers, one is a for and the other is an instead of trigger. And why we use the trigger? When you see the real example, then you will be clear with the triggers. Okay, so normally, so trigger basically maximum times you will be creating a trigger on the table. You are going to create a trigger on the table. Okay, you are going to create a trigger on the table. On the table, you are going to create a trigger for insert, for update, for delete, for instead of update, instead of insert, instead of delete. So for this all you are going to use update, delete and insert. Instead of also you are going to use update, delete and insert. Okay, so as I said, it executes when an event occurs. What is an event? Update, delete, insert is an event. So if you give for update and for insert, whatever you do at that time, the trigger fires, because you are going to create trigger on the table. Automatically the trigger fires, and whatever operation you do in the trigger, it will get executed. Normally in the triggers there are two magic tables. When I explained about the merge command, I have said two magic tables. Durga, what are the two magic tables I explained in the merge command? Hello?
Yeah, Bhaskar.
Yeah, I explained you some magic tables. What are the two magic tables I explained you? Hello?
Sorry, Bhaskar, I forgot that.
Okay, no problem. Yeah, Likita, can you say? I explained about the merge command, right? Merge, you do the target as target using source table name. At the end of the merge command, we got what are the records inserted, what are records deleted. We called from output, we called from table name dot column name. We used two tables there. Inserted and deleted.
Inserted and deleted.
These are the two tables that we have in the, that we have magic tables in. So in the trigger also the two tables will be automatically created. So once you see the example, then you will be clear with that. So my scenario is that this is the normal thing. Add one scenario where I am adding one table for SSN details. Okay, let's say it is SSN. So it will have some SSN ID and it will have SSN number, and it will have the name of the SSN, who is holding his name. Okay, this is a thing that I have. Now I am adding some records 101, 102, 103. 104 SSN. I got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We'll have 9 digits, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Something. Okay. These are the three SSN numbers I got. This is Abhilash. Let's say it is Abhilash. And this is Raghava. This is Praveen. This is some Savitri. Okay. We got multiple. Four records we got. What is my scenario? Is it someone updates, someone updated this data. Okay. Someone updated this data, and he updated data from instead of 89, ये अपडेटेड टू 1 2 3 4 7 6 7 9 10 9 1 0 1. दिस इज अ रिकॉर्ड दैट ही अपडेटेड रॉन्गली. 4 5 6 7 8 9. ओके लेट्स से इट्स अ 0. ओके सो समवन अपडेटेड द एसएसएन डेटा. हाउ कैन आई नो हु अपडेटेड एंड हु डिड. बट व्हाट माय सिनेरियो इज इट whenever someone updates the data or whenever someone deletes the data from this, my scenario is that I want to store the data in one backup table. Like, so this table has been updated by some user, so how I want to store this one, I want to store 101, same I want to store the user ID old value 5 6 7 8 9 and is Abhilash, and next I want to have the new value also 101 123 46791 Abhilash. And along with that, I'll be adding one more column here, user ID at the end. That will have the which user did that thing, okay? And what is the operation, whether it is inserted or updated one, like that. I want to do that one. How can you do that? Like you have learned many things in the T-SQL right up to now. So do you know any scenario that we can do that way? Whenever someone updates or deletes a record, automatically that updated record, deleted record. If the record is updated, the previous value and the new value. If the record is deleted, that record, deleted record. If the record is new record inserted, the inserted record. And at the same time, I also want to capture who inserted and who deleted, who updated. That all and username I want to capture. So that if someone updates the table, automatically I can see that who updated and who deleted. Because if nothing is there, how can I know who deleted the record and who updated the record? We can't find. It is hard to find. Okay. So for that purpose, I want to have some. I can call this table as log table. So this is SSN details, right? I'll call it as SSN details log. So whoever does anything, that one will be logged into this table. So I want this scenario to happen. So what are the scenarios that we have to do this? Can anyone say?
We are creating the after trigger.
No, Shilpa, please. I want others to say.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead. Because you don't know the trigger, right? Is there any other way without using the trigger? Can you do this? Hello? Hello? No. Think. It should be automatically done. Okay. So for this purpose, we can create trigger. So whatever what the trigger does, so we are going to create one trigger. Okay, first step we are going to create a trigger. So in the we are going to create a trigger since we are inserting the data, right? I'll create a trigger for insert. What happens in the trigger? I'll write a logic. So whenever I does insert, automatically this trigger will fire. Okay. So there are two things, whether this trigger should fire after inserting the values into the database or before inserting the values into the database. That is, you can capture by using for insert and instead of insert. The two things you can say accordingly, like I want this trigger to fire. I have created a trigger for insert. So whenever there is an insert, automatically the trigger will fire. Okay. And like once you see the example, then you will be clear, nothing to worry. So there are two types of triggers for and based on that, if you give for, the trigger will fire after inserting the value into the table. If it is instead of, then the trigger will fire before inserting the value. First we will go with a simple example, then you will be okay. What I'll be doing is that now I'll connect to the database engine. This database, I'll create a normal table. Create table, same I'll write SSN details. SSN details. I'll give some ID as integer. I'll get an SSN number as I'll give where char as integer, anything where char of 90 digits, right? I'll just give 9. Next I'll give SSN name. I'll get a where char as name. Okay, I'll just execute the table. Done. It is in the test database. Refresh it. So the table is created with SSN details somewhere here. I'll just right click, edit 200 rows. I'll just insert the values here. I'll give the value so that you will be also running the script, right? Insert into SSN details. Values, or else I'll give this. Oh, I already did, right? Okay, I'll give ID as 1 comma SSN number something 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Done. SSN name I'll give it as some Raju. This will be 2 comma. I'll give something 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 9, and I'll give name it as Raghava. Next 3 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Instead of Raghava, what will I give? Raghu, Raghu, Raghu. Next I give some Pravalika. Okay, so this is the thing I'll give. I'll just insert the values. Now if you see the data from there, you can see 3 records. Select star from. Now what I want, if someone updates the data from this, if someone updates the updates some data, so what will after updating, what is the old data and what is the new data? I want to store that in one some tables. Okay, so in the trigger what happens automatically in that, I'll show you. So whenever you want to capture anything, so just you create a trigger. So the basic trigger is that just you'll give create normally, and you'll give object name. It is a create trigger, right? Trigger is a object, and they'll give, then you give the trigger name. I'll name it as tg underscore update. I'm going to create a trigger for update. Okay, update SSN details, and after doing that you give on which table. The table name is SSN details. Details, and here after you give for. Now, what is the thing you are going to give is that here you will get the trigger type. After giving the table name, you will give the trigger type. So what I want, there are two types of triggers. One is a for or after. Both are same. Even you can start the trigger with for. You can start with trigger after. Both are same. And second is a instead of. But the standard name they'll use is instead of after, they'll use only for as a name. That's it. Now see, I want to create trigger. So what for does, what after does, what instead of does, we are going to see. First worry about the for trigger. We are going to see the instead of also. First we worry about the for trigger. What I want is that now I'll write for update. If someone updates the data on this table, I want to capture that event into one table. So before that I need to also create one more table. Create same table. I'll write, I'll name the table as a log. Control C. I'll name the table SSN details log. and here same will be there. Along that I'll have insert action date as date time. I'll give default as get date. So it will done. So there will be not, I'll not be inserting that. And next one is that I'll give action date, I'll give action type. I'll give 50 or anything. Next, user, username. Where can I have 50? Okay. So this is a table which I have created. This is a log table. Done. Now, what is my thing? Is that I'll write one code here. I'll just give one for update trigger. After that, as whenever the trigger fires, automatically, suppose if you update some data, remember it is byad, okay? Let's say you updated some data or you created a trigger for insert. So in trigger there is inserted updated, so inserted deleted. There are two magic tables, right? What happens whenever you insert, the data will be inserted into the inserted table, and since there is no, so data deleted table will have blank values. Whenever you do update, what happens? Updated data will be there in the, in whenever you do update, update is a different thing. The old data will be there in the deleted. Let's say you are updating some name ABC to some BCD. So ABC, the old data will be there in the delete, and the new data will be there in the inserted. Okay, updated data will be there in both the tables. And if you see the deleted, then the deleted data will be there only in the deleted table. In the inserted table, it will not have anything. It will have only data in the deleted. Okay, see, inserted means you can get the data from inserted table. Updated means you can get the old data from the deleted and new data from the inserted. Deleted means you can get the deleted data from the deleted table, because just you are deleting, right? So inserted data, even though if you can get data from the inserted, but you will not have any inserted data in that. Okay, now see, since what I want, my scenario is that if someone updates this table, if someone updates the data in the SSN details, what I want to capture is that I want to capture the old record and the new record, and at what time that they updated it, and who updated, and what is the action they updated, like whether they updated or whether deleted. Okay, the two things we need to know. For that purpose, just I'll write a query first. What I'll write? Select ID. So whatever the columns are there in the table, by default that structure will be of these columns only. On what table you created, so that it will follow the same structure. So you can call all the columns. I'll give ID, SSN, comma, SSN name, comma, SSN from deleted table. Deleted table means it will have the old data. And if you do the same thing from inserted, then it will have the new data. Okay, from inserted. This will have the new data. My scenario is that I want to insert them into the data, into the table. So what is my table name? My table name is SSN details. Okay, so what I'll write here first, I'll just write insert into SSN details log table. I'll give column names. What are the column names I got? ID, SSN, SSN name. Yeah, can you all please mute your microphone? SSN. SSN name. After the SSN name, just I'll have action date. I'll explain, nothing to worry. It's a just a confusing one. I'll just give action type. Come on, username. I'll just give values. Now here, so instead of values, what I want, I want everything from the inserted table. So just say, so I got SSN ID, SSN, I got SSID, SSN, SSN and SSN name from the deleted table. Okay, but I want to get the action date, action type. I can ignore the action date because I have given default, right? I'll not do anything. By default, it will take the action date. Whatever the current date is, it will take action type. So action type is by default I will do, since I have created the trigger for update. So what, which data will be there in the deleted? I'll have the update, and it will be the deleted update new. I'll just write as new as action, and after this action type, right? Next I want the username. So for the username, just you will use username as a function. Oh, I think it's a user underscore name or something. Yeah, okay. So when you use the, when you do the username, automatically you will be getting the systems. I'll just do select username. Yeah, when I do this, now I'll get the system username. See, my name is Bhaskar, right? Oh, actually it is taking, I think we don't want this then. Something we have, the rate of either username or I think sys user something. SYS, yeah, system user. Yeah, when you use a system user, who is the current user on the system, you'll get that username. So yeah, I'll just use system user as username. As username. Okay, that is for the deleted. Same thing for the deleted. Now we'll do for the insert. I'll just copy this. Same scenario for the, because the old new data will be inserted, right? Oh, this is updated old deleted table. So it will have updated old. This is updated new. Action type, system user, username. That's it. And this will be inserted table. That's it. Go. Okay. So what happens now? First, so see one scenario here. What we are doing in the create triggered one? We are taking the data from the deleted table, and then after that we are deriving, these are the SSN ID, name SSN, SSN name are the, we are getting directly from the deleted table. And after that, this action type we are manually doing. If the table, if the data comes from deleted, it is updated old. If and we are giving which user done that. Okay, and same time we also did for the insertion also, the old, because whenever we do update, the old record by default it will be inserted into the deleted table, and the new record will be inserted into the inserted table. So we are taking the, we are done with the deleted record, old record, we are doing the new record. So in the new record, this is updated one, new, right? So I'll give updated new and action type and a system user. By default I'll give. So what happens, this one I'll show you now. So this is the operation. In the trigger, what happened? First I have created trigger, right? So this is a table. Table, and next after the table I got a trigger. On the trigger, on the table I got a trigger. So the trigger is, I have created trigger for update, right? I have created trigger for update. For update. Remember, it is for update. Okay. So when someone tries to delete the insert on the table, whenever when someone wants tries to insert the data, so what happens? It will system will insert the data. After inserting data, it will check whether there is a trigger or not. For insert, we don't have any trigger, so no problem. This trigger will not execute. Let's say if someone wants to update the data, so what happens? First, the data will be updated on the table. After that, the trigger will fire. So whatever operation you are creating, whatever the query you have written in the trigger, that query will execute automatically. Okay, this is for. Even you give after also, it works. Are you able to get this? Hello? Hello?
Yes, Master.
Likita, Monica, Master. Durga, Dhanalakshmi,
yes,
Shilpa?
Yes,
so now let's check that whether it will work or not. It will work for only for updates, not for insert. If you want for insert, you need to create a new one. Okay? So now what I will do? You can create here also in this. You can create here. You can instead of update, you can, if you want to give the multiple triggers, just you can add multiple triggers. How many triggers you want, you can add your triggers here. Okay, so now what I am going to do, just I am going to insert the data into the trigger. I'll just I didn't create a trigger, right? Trigger and this log table I didn't create, so I created them. Oh, sorry, it said the trigger must be only one statement, so first I'll create the log statement. Okay, the table is created, then I'll execute the trigger. Done, trigger is created. Now what I'm going to do now, I'll just get the new query, vertical tab. Whatever the table I got here, so just now I'll select the data from this log table. Select star from SSN details underscore log. When I do, I'll get the data. See, there is no data now in the log table. Now let's see the SSN details. Now what happens? I'll update the, oh, I didn't execute, right? I'll update the SSN details table. Done. I'll update the SSN details table from Raghu to Raju, Raghu to Ramu. Okay, I'll update this name to Ramu and see now. And I'll update the, let's say I'll update Raghava's SSN. I'll not update anything. I'll update Raghava's SSN. Okay, now let's see. Update. Normally we give the table name. Table name is SSN details. I'll just update this table. That's it. I'll just update. Update SSN details. After that, set SSN equal to. I'll update some SSN. 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Updated. Where ID equal to 2. That is Raghavas, right? I updated. So when I do update, normally whenever you do, what will be your result? Normally when you update or insert, you will get number of records updated, right? If you update multiple records, it will show the number of records updated. But currently we are updating only one record. It should show one only, right? But when you execute, you can see multiple things. Three times it is showing. Means one is for your and rest other two is for the trigger. Because trigger at the back end, trigger is also execute. Now you can see here. When I do this table, select star from SSN details log, I just updated the SSN details table. I didn't even touch with the details log. But since we have created a trigger on the SSN details, stating this, what we stated is that whenever there is an update on the table, please insert that old and new record of the updated old value and the new value into this SSN detail. That was the operation we had asked the trigger to do. So now when I do this, see, you can see two records. This is a old record, right? You can see updated old, and this is a new record. See, you can see updated, and this is a username that I have. So normally in the companies, you give this one to track the changes on the table, because there will be some important. And one more thing, whenever you do, instead of updating one record, it updated three records in the messages, right? When you did, it updated three records in the message. In that, again, I'll update. It will show three records. Now the same record will be inserted two times. Updated old and updated, because we are updated the same record, right? Updated old and updated new. But messages you got last time when I updated it, you got the message as three times it is being affected, that row. Means you are doing multiple operations. So if you create a trigger on the table where you are inserting millions of records, it normally, if the table takes like 10 minutes to insert the data, but if you create a trigger, it will take double the time. Or sometimes it may take more also. So creating a trigger means it will reduce the performance. But if you are inserting only one or two records, you can create a trigger. It's not an issue. But when you try to capture the events by creating a trigger in thousands of records, then it's a waste of time. Waste of time means the performance will be reduced. So everyone is okay for update for trigger? Hello?
Yes.
Yeah. So my scenario is that I want to capture an event where I don't want to do anything on the table. If someone tries to delete, I don't want to delete the data on the table. I don't want to delete the data onto the table. Okay, this is other type of trigger. Or else I'll just go with the same thing. Control Z, I'll go. So if you want to do the same thing for insert, just to write a insert, and whatever the data you get from the, because insert means you will be getting from the inserted table only. So you will get the insert and you will get operation as insert only. Whenever you do, you can create a trigger for delete also. If some, because now if I insert the data into the table, it will not do anything. it will not capture anything because I didn't. Whenever you try to insert the data, it will not be captured in the SSL details log table because I didn't ask the trigger to do any other operation except if they update that operation only. I'll be capturing. I can't. I'm not capturing any insert or anything. If you want to capture, you can capture. That will be your assignment to capture that. Okay, and here. Just you can give insert and you can give delete. If you want to capture the insert deleted events, deleted records, you can give delete here for delete. If you want to capture the insert, you can give for insert. And the only thing is, if you have multiple things, just you can give update delete. If you want to capture two things, you can give this way, update comma delete, two things in the same thing. Okay, if you want to give multiple triggers, okay, that's not. But I've just given only one trigger. Now my scenario, you create for update and insert. Sorry, update I have created. You create for delete. You create for delete and insert. I want two triggers you all to create for delete and for insert. Okay. Now what my scenario? I don't want any user to delete the data from this table. One thing you can do is that you don't give delete permission to the user. But my scenario is that I don't want the user to delete. I don't want the user to delete the data into the table. So for that purpose, I'll just create trigger. I'll just copy the syntax because I'll just name this one only. So here, update SSN details. Right? I'll just give trigger delete. I'll give anything. Okay. So here, instead of for trigger, you'll just give instead of delete, and in the as condition I'll just print a message, don't you are not eligible to it will not allow you to don't delete the yeah delete error in deleting the record. I want to print a message. That done. I can even capture from the deleted table also. Error in deleting the record. The following record is not deleted. And now I can call from the delete. Select star from. Done. That's it. So what happens when you do the so listen careful, this is the main concept you need to understand. I got two triggers, that is a for trigger or after, but basically we call with the for only. Next is the instead of. What happens when you do the for trigger? First, whatever operation, let's say I have created trigger for update, so that update action will occur first on the table. After that, the trigger will execute table, and after that trigger will execute. That is for the for trigger. What about the instead of trigger? In the instead of trigger, if you do any operation on the table, if you do any operation, that operation will not occur on the table. Instead of, the trigger will fire. Let's say I'm doing for delete, right? If I do a delete, if I create instead of trigger for delete, what happened? If I try to delete the data from the table, what happened? The data will be, that delete operation will not perform here because we have created a instead of delete trigger. So what happens? Instead of the deleting the data, it will just go and execute the trigger. That's it. So what operation within the trigger, that will happen, and after that it will not delete any table. So instead of deleting the data from the table, automatically this trigger will fire. Nothing will, you can't, when you try to delete the data, instead of deleting, it will go and execute the trigger. But here first it will insert and after that the trigger will fire. But here, instead of executing the table first, the trigger will fire. That's it. After trigger, it will not execute the table because here it's first you are inserting the data into the table, you are updating the data into the table. After that, the trigger will execute. But here, nothing will happen on the table. For if you create delete for the, if you give instead of delete, nothing will be deleted from the page. Whenever you try to delete, automatically the trigger will fire. Whatever the operation you are given the trigger, that will execute. Now see, I have created the deleted trigger, right? So what I am going to do, so this is up, and I even selected the data which data is trying to delete. Okay, create trigger, execute, done. I have executed. Now what my scenario is that I'll just see SSN details. Now I'll try to delete some data, delete from SSN details where ID equal to 1. When I try to delete it, what happens? See, what is the thing I have given? I have given, see, the record which is trying to delete, that record I got it here. I have given 1, right? But the messages, it will be printing in the message folder. Error in deleting the record, the following record is not deleted, because whenever you use a print command, it will be shown in the this one, in the messages, not in the results. So, and after that, what I did, what are the record is trying to delete, I'm getting that record. That's it. Now go and see whether that one record is deleted or not. I'm executing. See, one record is not deleted. It is as it is. Okay. So this is the way how you are going to do this, all the stuff. Or if I want to capture the delete also, I can capture in variables also, nothing to worry. So instead of print, I'll just write select. So I'll be getting multiple screens. So if I want to alter existing trigger, just write instead of create, just write alter. I'll just write here, it will be alter. I'm just writing to create. Okay. Now I'll try to delete the record again. I'll try to delete the record too. What happens? See error in deleting the record. The following record is not deleted. See, you got the data, but at the back end, the data will not be deleted from the table. See, 2 is not deleted. That is an instead of trigger. So instead of means instead of that event. Event means update, delete, or insert. The trigger will fire. So whatever the day, so in the trigger I can delete if I want. If I write delete the from table name where ID equal to this deleted ID, if I give, then it will be deleted. So accordingly, please. So accordingly, you can write the trigger. So what we have seen two types of triggers. One is for the inserted, and one is for the fur, and another is for the instead of. When you use the fur, so in the fur you can write any actions. First, what happens when you use the fur? Whatever the event you had for which event you created the fur trigger, like insert, update, or delete. First, that event will execute on the table, and after that the trigger will fire. But the other type is instead of trigger. So in the instead of trigger, first trigger that action will not occur on the table, just the trigger will fire. That's it. That is a major difference between, you need to remember that. Okay, so as I said, there are two types of triggers, fur trigger and instead of trigger. So when you create fur trigger for a certain event, event means it may be insert, it may be update, it may be delete. So what happens here? First, that whatever the thing you did for the trigger, that operation will occur here, and after performing the operation of the table, then the trigger will fire. In the trigger, you are given all the thing, right? Like we had asked you to insert the data into some log table. Okay, instead of trigger. So in the instead of trigger, what we have done, we have just loaded the data. So let's say not loaded, sorry, I read long word. So in the instead of trigger, I have created a trigger for delete or for insert. If I say I have created a trigger for insert, so what happens? And this is a trigger. So if we try to do some operation, insert on the data on the table, what happens? That data will not be inserted, but the trigger will fire. That's it. That trigger will be executed. So in the trigger, we can write some logic, whatever logic we want to write, we can write it there. So everyone is clear with the triggers? Hello? Hello?